If I knew pink was an option, I would have been buying pink battery cable for all of my electrical. It's amazing.
Welcome back. If you are new here, I am a solo van builder. First time converting my empty cargo van into a home on wheels. And in today's episode, I am adding my DC to DC charging. This is gonna allow me to charge my battery bank from my van's house battery while I'm driving. This is probably one of the simpler electrical installs I've done, though I won't say that Victron's instructions were any help. But basically, you have your DC to DC charger, and then there are three main terminals where your wire is gonna go, two hot wires and one neutral wire. Older chargers have two hot wires and two black wires, but this newer charger doesn't pull a neutral wire from the van's house battery like some of the older models. The end of the red wire that goes on your van's house battery requires a lug, and the end of the red wire that goes into the DC to DC charger can use a ferrule or not, depending on your wire size. There's a chart in the instructions that you should reference.
And heat shrink. I was using the heat shrink gun off camera view because the outlet is over there. And I'm like heat shrinking and I'm like, oh my gosh, why does it smell like burnt barbecue? Guys, there's a stink bug that's now burnt to a crisp that I guess was lodged inside the interior of the heat gun. His legs just fell out. That's so gross. So if you have the smart battery charger, you're going to want to take off this little front housing here.
And there's two screws, and then it's going to reveal your terminals. So out is going to be your red, in is going to be your red from your alternator, and then ground is going to be your black. The out and the ground are both going to go to your links. When you unscrew these little screws, it will lift up, reveal the inside of the terminal, and then you can screw it back down. And it's really important that you use torque. So according to the manual, it's 1.6 meters. So that is really important. There is a lot of power situation going on here. You want to be tightening these according to spec. And if you don't know about torque, I literally have the most amazing digital torque wrench, and it's small enough because a lot of the torque wrenches that you're finding are like for like lugs and stuff on Amazon. But I took my time. I found one and I'll link it in the description. What you want to make sure is when you're putting it in this terminal that the insulation is sitting in this housing here so that you don't have the exposed wire sitting in the plastic. It's just best practice. Don't ask me how I know that. I've just seen things. Twist it a little bit like this just so they're all kind of going in the same direction. And then when you're putting it in the housing, you can kind of turn the wire slowly as well so every single one of those strands gets housed. I bought this on Amazon. It was supposed to be red, but it's actually pink. But I mean, I'm totally fine with it. I don't mind. And when you're getting this wire, you want to make sure that it has like good reviews. I know maybe that's silly to say, but this is going in like a really important application, and you don't want some bootleg stuff that's bad. And then I'm using 6 gauge from the alternator to the battery charger, the DC to DC charger. But yeah, this is totally pink. That's ridiculous. I actually don't love it. The insulation is kind of like plasticky. I don't know. I'm actually not gonna be using this. I don't like the jacketing. There's no temperature rating printed on the jacket either. It just feels very plasticky and I just have a bad feeling about it. I feel like in electrical stuff, if you have like a bad feeling, you have to go with your gut. So I'm gonna be returning this to Amazon and I'm gonna go with Windy Nation. It's a little bit more expensive, but Windy Nation literally is a legit company. They've always had amazing quality wire and hopefully they have a next day option. Otherwise this project will be tabled for another 4 days. Bye bye pink wire. So finally the proper wire came from Windy Nation. Honestly, when you're ordering stuff on Amazon, it's really hard to know what's legit.
you could have a ton of really good reviews, and then for whatever reason, the seller could send you like a different variation or a different version of what you ordered. And that other wire just wasn't, I could just tell something was off with it. So go with my trusted standby, and it's not too expensive either, but it's definitely really good quality.
So I found that this is the best route to bring the wire from your DC to DC charger through to the van battery. You have to take off the side panel screw, the screws that are on side of the seat, the screws in this step, and then a few screws up on the floorboard here. You know, for me, when I was starting this project, it seemed really daunting to basically take apart the van, but I promise you, it's really not that hard. I do recommend keeping track of which screws go where.
Okay.
The first thing we need to do before we do anything is disconnect the negative battery terminal. So the first thing you're going to do is lift the switch here, and then I'm going to use a wrench to remove the nut that's holding the battery cable on the negative. Now that the negative is disconnected, I'm removing the red housing that is over the positive side of the battery, which is going to reveal the area where we can create like a stud to allow the fuse to sit. First, I'm using a wrench to loosen the clamp that is holding this housing down, and I'm putting a bolt through the bottom. This one is a square head bolt, but I think you would be fine with a round bolt as long as it's flush in that housing and doesn't stick out beyond the housing so it hits the battery when you put everything back together.
Just when I thought that maybe I was missing something, the right fuse, it says that it was delivered in the mailbox. Hopefully it's there, otherwise this is gonna push back the install even more. Ah.
At this point, I was just deciding where the best route for this wire was coming from that DC to DC charger, and also deciding how much wire loom to use to make sure the wire is protected against the sharp edges in the van. And then I just used some electrical tape to kind of fasten it down. There was kind of like a plastic track where other van wires were already fed, and this was basically perfect for my wire. There was enough room to add that additional wire. Here I am feeding it through that driver's side column. This was a little bit of a pain, but we got it done. This reminds me of the Addams Family. So I felt like the best way to bring it from that floorboard piece up into the back of the van was through this sidewall, simply because I didn't want to have any issues with like the wire on the floor when I frame this out or when I have the walls. There actually is plenty of space behind this, and then also this can sit where it sits naturally, and there's a good, I mean, there's got to be 3/4 of an inch back here. There's like foam separators, so this is fine. And then I'm just going to run this behind all of my supports, and then I'll show you. The bed is gonna have a beam that goes across here, which is perfect because it ends up in my electrical box. So I will run that cable up under the beam and into my electrical box, which will have my DC to DC charger. I'm actually not sure where I'm gonna put it. I wanted to flat mount it there, but it says that it needs to be mounted vertical with the terminals facing down. So we'll see where I figure out to put it. It's all installed. Let's test it out. I don't have another camera, so I can't show you like live, like right now, me reacting to it on the screen, but I will put what it looks like in the app here so you can see. But boom, we have bulk charging. It's charging. So now when I have a cloudy day, now when the sun isn't perfectly at the right pitch and the right angle, I will get some good charging on my massive battery bank back there. So when it's really hot, I can use my AC for my King Charles and not worry about him when I leave the van to go hit the mountain biking trails. That's all for now. Hope you enjoyed this video and don't forget to subscribe because the next one coming out is finally going to be my ceiling slats, and that is an epic one. You're definitely going to want to see it. Bye.